Hi and welcome to Cakes and Conversations, and today we're going to learn how to make modeling chocolate. This is a very simple recipe with just two ingredients. I have three here, I'll just explain it in a while. Okay, so it's just two ingredients and it's liquid glucose and it's chocolate. Okay, so I'm using here a blend of two chocolates, which is milk chocolate and dark chocolate. Okay, because I really like the balance, the sweetness and the bitterness that I get from both. Okay, so I'm using two, but you can use any one of them, that's completely fine. So this is almost like 90 grams of liquid glucose, and this is 227 grams collectively, both chocolates. So if you're doing same like me, like 50-50, so it's 113 and 114 grams. Okay, so first we're just gonna melt this chocolate in a microwave. I'm using a microwave safe bowl. I'm just keeping this on the side. So I'm just gonna melt, I've mixed both the chocolates and I'm just gonna melt this in the microwave, and we need it completely melted, no chunks and all. So I'm gonna melt this in the microwave at 30 seconds intervals. Do not keep it more than 30 seconds or something, because your chocolate might burn. Okay, so 30 seconds stir, 30 seconds stir, 30 seconds stir, and that's how you're gonna heat it up until it's completely melted. So if you see, it looks like this, but it's just melted. I just did for a minute, so basically 30 seconds stop stir, 30 seconds stop stir, that's it. For this chocolate, you don't need much. And now the remaining chunks will just heat up, I mean, will melt with the heat of the other melted chocolate. So if you see the color, I actually like this blend of dark and milk both. I make my ganache also the same way. We do not need lumps, otherwise your modeling chocolate also will have lumps. Okay, so we need it completely liquid. If you doubt, please strain the chocolate or just heat it up a little extra. Maybe just go for 30 seconds more. Because how would you like a modeling chocolate with lumps? I mean, modeling chocolate is something like fondant. So you can cover your cakes with modeling chocolate. You can make roses out of modeling chocolate. You can sculpt out of modeling chocolate. If your modeling chocolate will have lumps, of course you will not get a very good finished product. Okay, so now it's completely melted. I can be 100% sure of, okay. So now I'm gonna put liquid glucose in this, but of course I'm gonna heat this up also, but not so much, again just 20 to 30 seconds. We just need the liquid glucose to be a little warm. Reason why, it's easy to tip out also, because if you see, it's gonna take me ages for this to come out from the bowl. So I'm just gonna microwave it quickly just for 20 seconds and then I'm gonna put it in this one. So I've heated up it, or I've warmed it. I'm just gonna add it in this. If you see, it's so easy for me to just take it out when it's hot. So liquid glucose and chocolate both have a tendency to firm up. That is the only reason that your modeling chocolate firms up. Okay, it seizes and firms up like a clay. Mix it. You will, when you keep mixing it, you will see that your chocolate is going to seize up. Did you see? It gave me like a very thick ganache look. It was very flowy before, and you see how it is now. It's become like a frosting. You cannot frost with it, don't get me wrong here. It's like a clay, if you see. So I'm just gonna set it up. I'm gonna set this up for like an hour so that it firms up more and becomes like a clay. I'll just show you how you need to set this up. I'm going to spread, or I'm going to take the cling film, spread it on my counter. Okay. gonna tip this off, the whole thing. Okay, I'm just going to wrap it a little flatter because so that it cools down quicker and firms up quicker. Okay. This is how you make your modeling chocolate. It's a very simple, easy recipe. So you can suggest modeling chocolate to those people who don't like to eat fondant. If they say I don't want fondant cakes, suggest them ganache or buttercream or modeling chocolate. This is chocolate. Okay, so it tastes yum. Of course, it's a very liquid right now. So I mean, not that liquid, but it is soft. Okay, so it's definitely gonna be this way. It's warm also, but once it's cooling down, and the more it cools down, the firmer it becomes. Okay, I'll show you how it is gonna look after it cools down a bit. Also, wanted to inform you that, you know, later once it's cooled down and it's firmed up, you might also see sometimes that it has a little bit of oil on it. Sometimes it happens. Do not worry, do not panic. Doesn't mean that it's got spoiled. So chocolate has fat, okay? So this will ooze out a bit of fat. Just knead it back into it. Just keep kneading it. It will go back. It will go back in the modeling chocolate, okay? And you can perfectly use it. Also, if it's very hard, because chocolate will tend to set up, so if it becomes very, very hard for you to handle it, pop it in the microwave just for 10 seconds and it'll be good and pliable to use. Okay, so I'll just show you how it looks after it cools down, maybe after an hour or so. I just wanted to tell you how much it weighs. This recipe or this batch weighs 318 grams. It's 318. All right, so I'll just come back after an hour and show you how it looks. So this is after 1 hour, okay, and this is how it's gonna be like. Let's just open it. It smells divine. Oh my god, it's all chocolate. Okay, so it's just gonna be quite hard. You have to knead it before you use it. Okay, so you will knead it. It's very much pliable. If you have warm hands, please use gloves and then knead it. So this is how it's gonna be like, okay? It's like a clay consistency now. So you can definitely make, you can mold it, or you can, you know, use it. People make roses, okay? I'm very, very bad at roses, so it's really good. You can make this with any chocolate, not only milk, dark or anything, but white also. This is a very great alternative for your fondants, and this is how it's gonna be. Okay, so this is modeling chocolate. If you have any questions or anything you want to say, so you can just post it below. You can flavor the white chocolate one, okay? You can add a little bit, when you melt the chocolate, so you can add a little oil based food coloring and flavor also, and oil based only, and then you can make flavored modeling chocolates too. So thank you so much for watching.